wonderful to see you again. I couldn't walk out without saying hello.
You know Reginald Hightower.
I didn't want you to get up, of course. Yes, Reggie. We met in Capri, summer of 1995. Sissy Waterman's villa.
Yes, I remember it very well. Nice to see you again,
nice
Vanessa.
Nice to see you. I don't want to interrupt you, gentlemen.
No, please, please don't rush off. No, Reggie and I would love to have you join us.
Right? Well,
no, I insist.
Thank you. Only for a moment, though. If Reggie promises to tell me what he's doing in Pine Valley.
Business. We were discussing Palmer's role in the future of Cortlandt Electronics.
Mm, what? You've got some wonderful new device on the works.
Well, he hopes to remain chairman of the board.
Of course he does. Why wouldn't he?
Well, because my insatiable wife received so many socks for our divorce settlement that she's now trying to replace me in my office.
What, destroy the company in the process? How foolish.
Well, you know, it's a vendetta. She's creating a crisis of confidence.
Ah. Reggie, surely you don't share that. You think Palmer should stay at the helm?
Well, frankly, I've been wondering if a change isn't for the best. The third and fourth quarter earnings were down.
Oh, well, simply because of the Asian market bottoming out. But Cortlandt stock is still blue chip. For heaven's sakes, Palmer's still the whiz kid. I mean, he's the one that created this whole new area. You know, you throw your weight behind an unknown. I'm afraid you're going to send some shivers all the way up and down Wall Street.
Perhaps you're right.
Well, a word of advice that I'm sure you've given others. Tain't broke, don't fix it.
Oh, you're right, Vanessa. Why take an unnecessary risk? Palmer, you've got my vote.
But
I want to be kept informed on the Y2K problem.
Oh, of course, absolutely.
Yes, well, you can thank Vanessa.
I certainly will.
Oh, please.
Well, my pilot's waiting. Why don't you be here? I would have arranged my schedule differently.
Oh, you're such a terrible flirt, Reggie. Now, go get your plane and tell Patsy hello.
Will do. Goodbye, Palmer.
Well, you can see the havoc that Opal is wreaking. I mean, even our most loyal board members are beginning to waver.
Oh, nonsense. Come on, Reggie knows you're a financial wizard. Besides, he just likes to be courted. Anyone else who needs reassurance?
No, I don't think so. I've been in conference every day this week.
Exhausting for you.
Yeah. But there is one person I really want to make sure of. That's Erica. In fact, I'm going to see her right away.
Oh, then you haven't heard. I mean,
no.
Poor Erica. It's absolutely heartbreaking. Erica's just determined to have this procedure done to her face, and it's still highly experimental, so I am so frightened for her. But what if something goes wrong? I mean, who's she going to turn to? I mean, even if everything goes perfectly well, it's got to be terrifying.
Erica does not lack courage.
And somehow I feel so protective. I mean, I think she feels the same way, too, because she did ask me to move in with her when she was recuperating. And of course, I said yes, but this infuriated some of her friends.
Yeah, including my ex-wife, I'm sure.
Well, I think Opal just felt she'd been replaced somehow. I mean, she badgered Erica constantly.
She never, ever stops interfering.
And there I was, all of a sudden, overstepping my bounds. I became a leech, abusing Erica's hospitality. I couldn't even bother to respond to that, honestly.
Well, good for you.
But I did move out, Palmer, because I couldn't have Erica defending me. Not now. The last thing in the world she needs is that.
You say Erica's going to be gone for a few more days?
Oh, possibly a few weeks.
Well, then, I think I'd better get down there to Brazil right away, because she's not going to be back in time for the vote. So I will leave just as soon as my jet is ready to go.
Palmer, you are a marvel. I love a man of action. Well, I'm sure that Erica's going to be delighted to see you. Will you let her know you're coming?
You think I should?
Oh, please, I'm the last person. I'm too afraid to give advice about Erica.
Oh, please, don't group me with that coven that she calls friends.
Oh, I'm sorry, Palmer. It's just that I'm afraid they're not the only ones who question my affection for Erica. My own son David does as well, you know.
Now, why is that?
No. Guilt? Jealousy? Habit? We haven't been close for years. Perhaps he resents my mothering someone else? I don't know. He resents me for almost everything else in the world.
You know, I have a son like that. Ross. We're practically strangers.
Oh, I'm sorry, Paul. There's nothing worse.
No.
This may sound strange coming from a mother, but David is no humanitarian, you know, in spite of his medical skills.
Well, I know David a little. He took care of my niece in New York.
Mm-hmm. Let me guess. He was terribly brilliant and terribly self-serving.
He saved a life. Then, of course, he secured a position at Pine Valley Hospital.
Uh-huh. Well, he saved Erica's life, too. Now she's supposed to be down on her knees in front of him for the rest of her life. Well, in spite of the fact, and never mind, that he caused the accident that robbed her of her beauty, well, you know something? I don't think she owes him a thing.
You and I think remarkably alike.
Do we? Oh, I hope so.
I wish we could continue this, but... Well, if I'm going to leave tomorrow, I'd better get to the office.
Oh, which reminds me, Erica needs some papers from Enchantment. I'd like to get them to her. Would you take them?
Of course.
What's best? Shall I drop them at your office?
I have a better idea.
Have dinner with me tonight. Bring the papers along, and we'll see what we can do about straightening out this problem you have with Erica.
Palmer, that would be lovely.